Hello. So good to see you again. This week, the Redland staff will be sharing some of Jesus' parables. Jesus often used parables or stories to paint a picture of the meaning of what he wanted to say. As they say, a picture is worth a thousand words, even if it's a word picture. When I was a young child attending Sunday school, I remember learning this simple definition of a parable. A parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning. Everyone likes to hear a good story. Our ears perk up at an interesting and engaging story, and at the end, it is always great when we can say, the moral of the story is, and then give that answer. Jesus often used these earthly stories to communicate his heavenly message. Today, we look at Luke chapter 15 and focus in on the parable of the prodigal son. This parable is the third of a three-part set. All are on the same theme of recovering something that is lost. In Luke 15, we read the parable or story of the lost sheep, the story of the lost coin, and this third story of the lost son. We remember these stories with a focus on the object or person that is lost, the sheep, the coin, and the prodigal. But I believe to see the heavenly meaning of these stories, we need to focus on who I consider to be the true main characters of each story. These main characters are the shepherd, the woman, and the father. The heavenly meaning of the first story is about a determined shepherd that values individually each and every one of his sheep. The heavenly meaning of the second story is about a thorough woman who will not let one coin go missing. And the heavenly meaning of the third story is about a loving father who is both giving and forgiving beyond earthly understanding. I recently saw the movie A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, starring Tom Hanks as Mr. Rogers. One of the things I had heard about Mr. Rogers that was depicted in this movie was how Mr. Rogers could talk with someone in such a way that person felt like they were the only person in the room. Mr. Rogers would focus solely on that conversation, making continuous eye contact with that one person. These conversations would even take place in the middle of the shooting schedule of his TV show. When he would be engaged in these conversations, his entire production crew would sit and wait. And to me, that is another great picture of how our Heavenly Father sees us. We have his undivided attention. He looks at us as if we are the only person in the room. He sacrifices in order to love each one of us. The meaning of these three parables is about a loving father that sees you and me and what we're going through. A caring father who knows your struggles and heartaches. A determined father that will never give up on you. A patient father who is waiting for you to come to him. So don't struggle alone. Don't hurt by yourself. Your heavenly father is right here to walk beside you. This Redland Baptist family is ready to be the earthly hands of God for your need. So if your path has led you away from God, maybe now is the time, even during this quarantine, to make a change for your life. And if you would like to talk with me or another one of our great staff, please email or call. We are available and would love to talk with you. At the end of each of these stories, we also see a picture of what I call a party dad that is thrilled to throw a celebration with you as the guest of honor. I can't help but think that at the end of this COVID deal, there will be an incredible global celebration. We will probably be able to view these celebrations on TV, much like we do New Year's Eve celebrations that move across time zones and countries. We will see celebrations in Australia and Asia and Africa and Europe and in North and South America. But as big as these celebrations will be, they will not hold a candle to the heavenly celebration that takes place when one person becomes a Christ follower. The heavenly meaning to these earthly stories is that the rejoicing in heaven is off the wall when one person who is turned away from following Christ comes back to him. It's hard to think of partying right now, but there is a heavenly party that is all set to go with blowers, streamers, noisemakers, music, and yes, even dancing. So what do you say? Let's get that party started. See you next time.
There's a party going on right here. A celebration to last throughout the years.